Hey guys, it's Christy and welcome back. Today I'm going to do my July favorites. So I'll go ahead and get started because I've got quite a few. The first thing that I've enjoyed is the Laura Mercier mineral pressed powder in real sands. It's got a mirror on this side, but I'll show you this side. And it's just a mineral foundation powder, and this doesn't make my face sting like the Bare Minerals does. And so I've really enjoyed that for summer, just to use that as my foundation, just over a BB cream or a tinted moisturizer. I've been using my Garnier Dark Skin Eraser. Yeah, well, Skin Renew Anti-Dark Circle Roller. I've been using that a lot this month, and I really enjoy that. It gives you just like a light coverage. For lips, I've got three lip combinations that I've been using quite a bit. The first one is Max Chatterbox, which is just a really pretty kind of intense pinky coral. And over that, I've been putting White Russian from Buxom, which is just a really pretty light pink. And then I've also been enjoying Max Cut the Caper, which was a re-promote, and it was re-promoted, which is when I got it, in the Heavenly Creatures collection that MAC just released. So this is just a really pretty coral color, and over it I've been wearing the MAC Cream Sheen Glass in Meteoric, which is also just a really pretty coral gloss. And I've also been wearing from the Sailor collection this lipstick in To Catch a Sailor, which is a really pretty kind of champagne-y bronze, I guess you would call it. And then over it I've been wearing the MAC gloss in Blessedly Rich. It's kind of hard to read because they wrote it in gold so it just blends in, but it's just a really pretty kind of coppery color. I've been really liking this brush from Eco Tools, and this is kind of a multi-use brush. You can use this for powder, you can use it for bronzer, you can use it for regular liquid foundation to blend it in. And I just think this is a really great all-around brush, and it compares a lot. It's pretty comparable to the Tarte brush, which Tarte just released a whole big bunch of brushes. I saw them the other day when I was at Ulta. And this is one of them. And this is a pretty good dupe for the way this brush performs. This brush from Tarte is a little, you know, it fans out a little bit more, but the performance of the brushes is virtually the same. So I really like this, and I think it's a really good deal. It's like $12, and this one I think is 36 or 38. Might be 34. It's in the 30s. I know that for sure. I got it in a kit, so I didn't, I got it with foundation. But I really like this, and I've used it, you know, for all three, for the bronzing, for the powder, and for the liquid, and I really like it. I like it most for bronzing and for powder, just because I haven't been using a whole lot of liquid foundation. Another brush that I've been really loving is this Tarte brush, and this is also a new brush, and I got this one in a set too, but they're selling them on their own, and it's $30-some as well. And this is for cream blush, and I really like it. Now, some people might not like it as much as I do because it does cover a significant amount of your face when you put it on, but you know, it, you can kind of see where it's going to hit. So if you don't like, you know, your brush or your blush like that, you can always just kind of, you know, squish your brush down and apply it, or get a smaller brush, because this is going to give you a pretty large area of application. But I think it does really, really well with cream blushes, and that's what it's intended for, is cream blushes. So this is their cream blush brush. And I've been using two cream blushes this month. They're both from NARS. The first one is Penny Lane, which is just a real pretty, let's see, kind of a pink color. That's what it looks like. And it's just like it's just a real nude, barely pink. And then the other one is Cactus Flower. And Cactus Flower is just gorgeous. And it's just a really pretty, like a, it's a red. Like a pinky red, I guess you would say. So that's Cactus Flower. And I really love those. And I've been using that Tarte brush to put them on with. My favorite eyeliner this month has been Copper Rider from Estee Lauder. And it's just a really pretty bronzy color. Kind of like, it's got a lot of red undertones to it. I have it on right now. And this Real Techniques brush from Samantha Chapman. This is their blush brush, and I don't like this so much for blush because it's pretty thick. It's kind of like the Tarte, but with the Tarte, I usually, not Tarte. I mean, it's like the Tarte. Yeah, I'm losing my flipping mind. Okay. It's going to give you the same amount of coverage as the Tarte brush would, as far as it's pretty thick, which to me is fine for the cream blushes, but I don't like that for powder, which I always put over the cream blushes. I always put some sort of powder to set it, unless I'm just going to be wearing it, you know, going to be out just a couple hours, then I might not. But so for that, I use a smaller blush brush, and I think this one is a little bit too big to be used as a blush brush because it's just, it's pretty huge. So, and the cream blushes that I have go on kind of sheer, so if I get, you know, a little bit out onto my cheeks, it just looks like I'm kind of glowing, so it's not that big of a deal. But for this one, I actually like to put on that Laura Mercier powder with it and just kind of buff it all over, and I think it works really well for that. So I like that brush. My favorite eye combo has been the Rubenesque Paint Pot from MAC. Under the new MAC eyeshadow from the Heavenly Creatures collection in Magnetic Attraction. And I use this wet, and I think this is a really, really pretty combination, these two together. I've also been enjoying the Bobbi Brown Rose Gold eyeshadow. It looks like that. It's just a really pretty rose gold color. And lastly, I just love this YSL Glossy Stain. And this is in number 13. And it's just a really pretty hot pink. And it doesn't, to me, it kind of smells like strawberry champagne or strawberry wine. But it doesn't have that nasty melon smell that the other ones have. And I actually have one of the other ones on right now. And I really love their golden glosses, but if you see my review, I can't take the taste or the smell of them, but I paid $30 a piece for them, so I'm going to wear them. But, at any rate, those are my favorites for this month. There's a review coming up on this Glossy Stain. If you want a review on anything else, just let me know. Don't forget to comment and subscribe, and I'll see you later. Thanks. Bye.